the future. What can I say? It's hard to predict. Playing on the big stage, you have everything to prove, and the future is uncertain. I'm trying to find the next one. The next great one.
Then with Smeal off, the Oilers pulled Dryden, and Wayne Gretzky finished off a three-way passing play with McDonald and Callaghan to tie the score.
In the National Hockey League, I played for 4 years, sort of towards the end of my career. I played with the Edmonton Oilers, then I got traded to the Vancouver Canucks. 1979 was the first year in the National Hockey League, 79-80 with the Edmonton Oilers. The first year we came, I was the captain, and maybe one of the older guys on a very young team. Usually Gretz's office was behind the net, but I think in this particular time, I think the puck cycled and I came around. I was down low in the corner. It was sort of a lot of firsts for everyone, and that was the first for Gretz, though. Point-wise, I think Gretz and I, we had a very, well, at the time, they called it the GMC line, and ended up being the second highest scoring line in the National Hockey League that year. Hey, how are you tonight? Good, thanks. During the winter months, it can be difficult. We do a lot of traveling. A lot of nights we're in a different town or a different city every night, and we have to dodge the weather sometimes. But for the most part, we're doing, you know, outside of tournaments and stuff where we go on weekends, we're doing, you know, 4 or 5 games a week. So we're pretty well, once the season starts, we're pretty well living out of a suitcase, or we're in a rink somewhere every night. One of the top prospects in this year's draft, Del Cole, is playing for Oshawa, and he's going to be, it'll be interesting to see him play tonight. I've seen him a couple play. 2 or 3 times already this year, so it's nice to watch players through the course of the season and see how they progress. Well, we gotta wait for Kev. Did you call Kev? No. Stay here? Okay, let's go. Today is a very important day for the NHL scouts. It's our mid-season meetings where all our guys meet at our head office to rank this year's prospects. There's no clear-cut number one this year, so it's going to be very interesting to see how this turns out.
Aaron Ekblad's next up.
I think one of the things that's underrated about him is how good he shoots the puck. And he really does have a hard, accurate shot. And we've seen it in some of Luke's videos there.
He has that quick release.
You can't get
in the lane on
it.
Have a big bomb.
You can't get in the lane.
But you also see him. You know, back it up or moving forward. Whatever. He's never standing still on the point there.
He does play with authority out there, and he does take charge on the play. His game has grown, and he can handle traffic, and he makes plays in traffic. But he's just he's kind of like an energy power guy out there. I do really think the best is yet to come.
I mean, Reinhardt, you're not going to get a guy, I think, in the draft that has a better on-ice awareness. I mean, he knows where everybody is on the ice.
Drysdale's really come on big time.
You have a guy that can create both ways. He can be a sniper for you, and he can be a setup guy.
One of the main differences in their games, and Pepe just pointed out, is that Drysdale can be a real power forward. I mean, he can really power through guys.
I'll be honest with you, going into this, there was no question in my mind, probably since at least November, that Bennett was going to be the top guy in the OHL.
Continually impresses and gets better all the time. And he's got that flair about him.
Well, I saw him in a game in Kingston Sunday afternoon. I don't think I saw his best game, but you can tell, obviously, he's got great skill. But the thing that impressed me is they were getting beat like 6-1, and he was still playing hard.
There is a line in between the guys, but it's such a fine line. It's going to be the team's preference, what they're looking for, but nobody's really going to go wrong with these guys. I know we're not going to get any criticism from our hockey colleagues, that's for sure. And I don't know that we'll get criticism, but we are making a statement there.
The number one player this year for NHL Central Scouting at our midterm meetings is Sam Bennett from the Kingston Frontenacs. The future of the next one has yet to unfold. I had hopes and dreams to play in the big stage. I was lucky enough to make it. But now I take my place from above. looking down to find the next ones of tomorrow.